Hey everyone, in this Gauss elimination example video, we are being asked to solve for the following 3x3 matrix using Gauss elimination, which means that we need to solve for our three unknown variables, x, y, and z, in the following system of linear equations. On the right here, I have placed the steps that we will follow in order to solve this system of equations using Gauss elimination. Through these steps, we will create an upper triangular matrix, which looks like this. And then we will use backward substitution to find the variables that are currently unknown to us. So we are basically just isolating for one of our variables and then using that backwards to solve for our other ones. To solve this, our first step says that we create an augmented matrix, which separates our coefficient matrix and our constant or scalar matrix like so. Now, in order to solve this matrix using Gauss elimination, we need to transform this equation into an upper triangular matrix, which means that we need to turn all elements below our main diagonal to zero. Then we will use backward substitution, like I stated earlier, to solve for the remaining variables. So we need to turn all these values here to zero. To accomplish this, we need to perform some row operations. The easiest way to do this is using the following scalar factor equation. So let's say that we want to make this element zero. We take this value minus our row that we are not changing, row 1 in this case, then multiply this by our factor, and that will set this number to the first number, ensuring that we always get 0. Then we must complete the same calculation for the remaining values in the row, with the initial scaling factor always staying the same. So through this technique, we can easily get our 1 and 4 values here to 0. So I'll just write this out like so, such that you can easily see all the calculations that were occurring. And there we go, this is our first set of row iterations complete, and you can see that all of our first column, except for the first element, is all zero as anticipated. Additionally, we lucked out here in that our other value in row 2 that we needed to turn to zero also did that. Therefore, since our matrix is now in upper triangular form, we are ready to begin solving using backward substitution. We have z equals minus 4 divided by minus 6, therefore z is equal to 0.666. It is better to leave our variables as fractions to eliminate truncation error, the error due to chopping off part of our numbers. However, to keep things simpler, I'm just going to work out in decimals. On to our next equation, we can adjust our equation such that we have 3 plus 1.222 divided by 1.5. Therefore, y is equal to 2.889. Lastly, we can now solve for our missing variable, x. We have 2 minus 2.889 minus 0.666, all divided by 2 is equal to minus 1.78. With Gauss elimination, we can actually go back and quickly validate our answers. Using our initial linear equations, we can just plug in our newly solved variables, and if the left and right hand side of our equations don't equal, then we know we made a mistake somewhere. As you can see here, this works out for all three equations. Therefore, these variables do solve our system of linear equations as expected. If your numbers are slightly off here in the validation stage, that is likely due to some truncation error that occurred during the process. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a 3x3 matrix using Gauss elimination. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.